hook up your tubing to your bag and pull all the flush through. Another thing you want to do is just kind of make sure this is tight on the end.
Is that what you're calling the manifold right there? Or,
yep.
Okay. And then that's it. Is that a transducer?
Yep.
Okay.
And come around here. Most places will change this out between every case. The syringe will they'll leave in. And just hang it up on here. I usually attach the transducer next, that way I know how much slack I have. And this little plastic thing, there's little squeeze tabs on the side here. So you squeeze that and this thing almost just drops off. And there's your transducer. And it just slides right in to here. And it'll click. Now it's in there nice and tight. Now you can see how much slack you have. This tubing runs in through here. And there's little teeth here. You usually want them all the way down. If they're not all the way down, it won't make a good seal. And then this part slides up and over. And there's usually a cap on here to protect for, you know, the sterility. You don't want anything to touch that, just like you don't want anything to touch here. So we'll take that one off. And I'll attach it there. And then this part clips down in here. So that's how that tubing gets connected. Now I guess we'll go over setting up, getting this ready to go. So usually that part will be done. We'll get the patient on the table, we'll drape them, and then once you're scrubbed in, you would start getting all this stuff ready. They drop it and you connect this to an end. Remember, it doesn't matter which end. And I'll need someone to be circulator. So I'm gonna hand this over to him. And what you're gonna do is take that syringe off that tubing right there.
Okay.
And connect the end on. You can just set that in that little bag right there. Alright, and now it clips into those two.
Perfect.
Yep. And that second one too. Alright. Now what I'll do is I'll grab, usually you'll have a 20cc syringe or a 30cc syringe and connect up to my tubing there. And also then we'll connect this. There's two ways to do it. Remember, you're gowned in gloves, so you can't just touch this and move it. But you can just take the ends and carefully screw it on without touching this. And then you'll take your bag. Drape your screen. Now the other way to do this, if you want, I don't care which way you do it on when you're testing, as long as you don't contaminate yourself. The other way to do it is you can put your bag on and then drape it over the edge. And then as a circulator, you would have to come back here.
Mm-hmm.
Just reach in through the plastic, like touching on the inside of the plastic, because that's contaminated anyway. And hook them up like that. And you have your small, your dome cover. And usually what you do is you put your fingers on the inside like this. And reach on the far side, on the edge. But see, I can touch it like this if my fingers are on the outside, and you cover up your dome or your eye. So now everything's covered. And if you're always, if you don't know what to do, you can always just read the screen. Check manifold, syringe assembly, we did that. put manifold assembly into the valve sensor, we did that. Pipe contrast, already done. Place tubing and contrast sensor, he did that. Press done to begin filling. So now it should start pulling back. And unclip that.
Unclip what?
This little plastic bin, a lot of times, if you don't clip it, it'll start leaking out when you change these over.
Uh-huh.
So people will clip it. So contrast doesn't drip out here. But that'll give you an error if you forget to unclip it. All right, so we'll let that pull up. And we'll see if it's going to error or not. It hasn't been.
But, so you, we didn't see you spike that contrast. I mean, was that already on? That was on the assist, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you, okay. Is that part of the package? Does the circulator do that? Or, I mean, how does that?
Circulator, just like spiking that
okay.
contrast.
Okay.
That contrast, you will use that until it's out.
Okay.
You won't have to,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Please hold for technical difficulties.
So then you'll get to this screen. And it's, you know, spike and hang sailing bag that's already been done. Basically just hit done through here until you get the purge.
So there was a button that you said to advance the syringe? You advanced it? Or
no, it's not. That's not supposed to happen.
Oh.
It's supposed to fill back, pull back contrast, and then it stops. But for some reason, it keeps going forward. Usually it purges a little bit just to get air out, but for some reason it wants to purge all the way forward. And if I can't get it to stop,
I'm going to have to cut this video. Sorry.
All right, well, I'll just kind of skip ahead.
Oh, it's right there.
Purge contrast and tubing from the screen into the syringe. Usually, you make how much, what do you want in your, have you guys gone over that yet?
Can
you? No, when you inflate a balloon, what do you inflate it with?
Atmosphere.
Hmm?
Atmosphere?
But what fluid goes into the balloon?
Let's see.
Mm-hmm.
50-50 mix, 50% contrast, 50% heparinized saline.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know that.
So.
And how many cc's?
Depends on the blend.
Oh, okay.
But we'd purge, I can do it later if this will work, but usually we have the syringe hooked up to here, and we'll purge and then flush, purge contrast, and then flush saline into this so we get our 50-50 mix. And then we bring it over to our table and we prep our inflator. So all we do, hook it up to here, our side port. Now you gotta remember to turn your stopcock that way. And push this yellow button, this is like the clutch or the brake, and then pull back. And it just sucks it all in.
Cool.
So once you do that, you get that big bubble up here, and remember we don't like bubbles, so. Give it a couple of taps, make all the bubbles go up to the top. And now we only need about between 15 to 10 cc's in there. So I'll just push that button with my thumb and push it up to like 12 cc's. And then you check in here, make sure there's no bubbles in here. And give it a few more twists to make sure there's none in the line. And we'll disconnect and we'll save this. Because we may need some more later, so we'll just set this aside. And that's just prepping the end of it. Same thing for the other one. Attach your three-way stop cock, hook up to the side port, turn it that way. And on this one, you pull the trigger and then pull back. And then let the trigger go and it'll fill up. Same thing, get all the bowls to the top, pull the trigger, push down. And there's a reason I'm doing it one-handed. A lot of times when you're in a case and it's busy, and you need to be able to do it one-handed because you need another hand on the wire to keep the wire from flopping off the table or holding, you know, the wire still so the doctor can pull out the balloon or the stent or whatever. So if you can do it one-handed, it's going to help you later on.
Okay, so are we putting that heparin isomin in there, or is that supposed to be the contrast in there?
Both, 50-50. 50%
okay, so
contrast, 50% heparin isomin.
It's just not working, that's why.
I can't simulate.
Oh, but that's where you would get it from. Okay.
All right, let's see here. If I can get it past that spot, it might work. Okay, so after you hit done, there'll be two screens that'll say do this and this, which is already done if you get to that one. So I'm gonna hit purge, because remember this tubing is full of air. You haven't flushed it yet. Just like flushing your manifold, you hook up to your things and you gotta flush it. So I'm gonna hit purge, and what normally happens is it'll shoot out contrast until it comes flowing out here. So all I'm gonna do is hook up to the side and put about 5 cc's in here. Because there's about 5 cc's in here, this line. So all I did was purge contrast through here, through this line into here. So now I'm gonna hit done. And now it's flush, and it'll flush for 10 seconds. So what it's going to do, once I hit flush, it's going to start bringing that heparinized saline through here and push all this contrast that's in this tubing into the syringe, making it 10 cc's. And by the time it's all done, and I'll give it a couple taps here. So now it's starting to push heparinized saline in there. And it gives me close to 20 cc's total for 50-50. 50% contrast, 50% heparinized saline. Then I'll go ahead and fill up my endoflares and set this aside. So we finished our flush. I'm gonna hit done. Done.
How many endoflares are you only prep? Just one?
Just one. Okay. I was just showing you each one. Done. Until you get to this screen. And it's gonna say start hand control calibration. Pick up the hand control. The top one with the C is for contrast. The bottom with the S is for saline. So you're going to hit OK, and then press and hold the contrast button. And it should be somewhere up around mid-20s to 30s. And so once that's done, it'll ask you to purge the tubing line again. You usually just purge it for about half a second. And then hit cancel. And now, on here, you guys can see the part that's similar to the Med-Rad. I got 4 for 10, 605 pressure, and a half second rise, just like that. The way you change them is you touch the screen. 4, enter, 4, let's change this to 8. And that's how you change it, real easy. And then when you're ready to inject, you hit inject, okay to arm injection, okay. And green light comes on. And it's ready to go. So that means when I press, and just like the Med-Rad, you press and hold it down. And I press and hold, this is going to deliver 4 cc's a second for a total of 8 cc's. That's it. That's how this works. Now you have some presets. You have, usually for the left coronary arteries, since there's usually more, we have it set up for 4 for 8. The right's usually smaller, so they usually have it set up at about 3 for 6 and less pressure. LV, AO, it could be anywhere 12 for 24. At usually just set up some docs like 900, some like 700, depends on the doc. Now inject, and it's going to ask you again because it's a larger injection with more pressure. Large injection, okay? okay, okay to arm injection. It gives you, asks you twice since it's a large injection. And then when I press and hold, and then it gives you another and other. So you have four presets on there. So while during the case, you just did your left coronary and you're taking the left catheter out, you're putting the right catheter in, you can go over there, tap RCA, and continue on going. What you also want to do during, usually when you're exchanging catheters, the best time to do it, start refill. So while you're taking your catheter out, you're refilling the contrast. Usually if you run out and the docs have to sit there and wait, they're not usually too happy. So try to remember to do that while you're taking catheters in and out, because they can't do any injections during that time anyways. So we'll let this fill and we'll see if it's going to malfunction again. And there's your contrast remaining, which is at 99.
Right. Unless the machine's like this?
Yep, exactly, except for the malfunction. Okay. So usually the only buttons you'll have to use is calibrate hand control. If for some reason you forget to do it, there's a button right there. Start calibration. Okay. There, that's done. Here's your start refill, which I won't touch because it's acting okay right now. And your end case. Oh, the only another thing I'm gonna test you guys on is not so much, you know, going through. I want you guys to go through and recognize your pressure limits. You don't want to have it set on this when you're injecting into the right. 12 to 24 at 900 PSI into the right coronary, especially if there's loose plaque or, yeah, you could cause some problems. That's the major thing I'm gonna test you guys on, is making sure the left and the right pressures are, you know, lower.
What's a good right pressure?
Usually, most of the docs have it at 400 to 500. For the left, it's usually about 600. And again, because there's more coronaries, there's more arteries on the left system than the right, typically.
So do you usually end up using your presets or setting them yourself? Presets are usually pretty good?
Yeah. And when you turn the system on, they're usually different. So. Before the doctor comes in, you start your case, you usually just run through your presets, make sure they're what you want. And if you're at a place with a lot of doctors, they'll have like a sheet saying whatever, what the preset which this doctor likes. So you can go ahead and say, oh, this doctor likes, some doctors like the other day, there's a doctor who likes 8 for 16. And then what we'll have you do is, after your case is over, you have to make a note of your contrast delivered. Every new place you go will want to know how much contrast, because that goes in the patient's record for that case. So just under contrast remaining, which is 86, you have contrast delivered, and I've delivered 32. And then we hit end case, okay to end case, okay. Shutdown system, no. We're using the syringe as much as that we can, because I only have one other backup syringe. So it says max recommended case per syringe 5, we're at 14. Use new syringe. I only have one extra, so no. To continue, disconnect and discard sealing high pressure tubing. So it's telling you to get rid of this stuff. Okay, and if you don't do that, it's not gonna let you continue. So in order to get past that, you have to lift this up, lift these out, and at that time, you take a new syringe or a new end cap, and we disconnect, being careful not to touch that, and we put our brand new syringe or stopcock on that, and that keeps it
sterile.
And if you're at a place where they just discard it all, you click that so it won't leak out when you take this off. connect here. And you prep new tubing and hook it back up. So that's the assist. And anyone have any questions?